politics of the economy with Republican pollster Bill McIntyre, Democratic pollster Margie O'Meara. Let me start with the Democrat. When you look at history and you look at what is an anemic economy right now, if you're the president of the United States and you're planning re-election, you ran on hope and change. What can you say this time?
Well, there are a few things. First, the progress that's been made since 2008, and when I talk to voters, they feel that things have improved since 2008. I mean, there was a poll recently that showed more people blame Congress and President Bush and Wall Street, former President Bush, than they blame President Obama. Another thing to look at and think about with those numbers and think about what it means for the dialogue is that they would have been a little bit higher, but we lost some jobs in the government sector. And private sector gains have been much less volatile and actually increased more. And in fact, the biggest drop-off was in Minnesota, where there was this huge fight that caused by Republicans. So Republicans have really kind of made this a more difficult climate than on top of what people are already feeling.
I think you probably wouldn't be that upset if President Obama ran around the country saying we need more government jobs.
Well, here's the issue. We can look at consumer confidence, and today consumer confidence has dropped to a lower level than we saw since 2009, and no incumbent president in this country has ever won re-election with consumer confidence as low as it is today. So what it says is at best he's facing a too close to call campaign, and the other reality is we have one more year to go till he can try to make it better. It's growing, economy's growing way too slowly, and history says sooner or later you're the guy, who's been there 4 years, you take the hit.
I want to show that consumer confidence number, because I know, Bill, it's a number you focus on a lot in your studies. I just want to bring it up here and ask Margie how the president deals with it, because this is the University of Michigan survey. Down in May, down in June, now it's down here in July in the danger zone, and incumbent presidents in recent history have been above 95. If you're above 95, you get reelected. If you're down here, it's a lot more dicey. This reminds me in some way of 1992, in which you had the economy was getting better. When George H.W. Bush, a Republican president, was there, it was getting better, but at a slow rate, and it was very hard to break the psychology. Voters had decided it's bad, and even though the data was there, the president couldn't convince them. Is President Obama going to have that same problem even if things start to get better?
Well, I think if the debate is who is actually paying more attention to voter struggles and who's really trying to focus on fixing the economy, it's clear that the president wins that debate over Republicans in Congress or over any of the Republican candidates for office. I mean, they are fighting over who's going to be farther to extreme, who's going to be signing the most extreme pledge, who's going to be holding up the most bills. They haven't introduced a single jobs bill. So if it really comes down to who is more interested in fixing the economy or who is like Mitt Romney trying to, you know, hope nobody asks him any tough questions, then it's going to be really clear who wins out in that debate.
I think a shorthand way to shorthand that is it a referendum or is it a choice? Is it a referendum on President Obama? Then these statistics are tough. Even you can see, you can say it's not my fault. It was worse when I came into office. Those are tough statistics. If you're the guy in charge, I don't care whether you're a D or an R, that's tough. If it's a choice, the president has a better chance, right?
Well, here's the reality. The reality is we've used this index since 1952. So what we know, as I said, no incumbent party has ever won with consumer confidence below 74. And here's the other thing. This consumer confidence scale normally changes a point or two. It dropped 8 points. We do tracking for CNBC every quarter in economic confidence. People say at now, right now, my wages are, I don't think my wages will go up. My housing values are the worst they've been. I don't think the market will go up. These are all lower than they've been at any point during this three-year recession. No incumbent president wants to face that electorate and says, give me another chance. Sooner or later, people say, I know that didn't work. What's the next guy? And that was that helped him in 2008. It could also, ironically, be the force that crushes him in 2012.
Well, let's set the politics aside to the degree we can. Democrat and Republican pollster, that's probably not easy. But when you do talk to voters, when you do your focus groups and you look at polling, what is it? Why are they so down? Why is that consumer confidence dropping so much?
Well, they're down for a few reasons. And one is the economy is not, you know, we have a ways to go, right? I think everybody can agree to that. And I think they look at Washington and they look at the debate in Washington and what just happened with the debt ceiling fight. And they say, here are some folks who are just not paying attention at all to what we're talking about. They are grandstanding. I mean, the Tea Party has highest unfavorables than they've ever had. Even Republicans say that the Tea Party had too much influence over the debt ceiling debate. So, you know, they're looking at the fighting in Washington where, even though it's been frustrated, folks have expressed frustration this week of how this all played out, the Republicans really have suffered the most in the polls from the debt ceiling debate. I mean, they may feel they won, but that's not what the voters feel. The voters feel they lost and feel that Republicans didn't do nearly as much for voters as Democrats in Congress or the president.
When you look ahead, I think you would concede the point the president's a gifted politician. Do you see, I think your firm is doing some polling for the Romney campaign, so I should be careful and open about that, but do you see, of all the Republican candidates for president, we don't know who the nominee will be, do you see a new and interesting, captivating economic message, or do you see a message that, if you were working for the other side, the president could say, that's the same old stuff. George W. Bush did that, and what did we get?
Well, what I would say is that the president's running on, we tried almost a $1 trillion stimulus, we had a $1 trillion health care bill, and we tried to believe that we can make sure we try to improve the economy because we can increase government spending. Instead, what happened
is... So do the Republicans have to run on a negative economic message? Is there anything positive about their new and different thing they're doing?
I think what we can say is we tried what the president said would work, and it failed. And whenever that's happened, people are willing to look to who was the other guy. Now, I think our party is a long way to go. I think our party nominee is a long way to go to reiterate what is a different idea. But, by the way, I believe that what we know for sure, and let me talk about President Obama in 2008, and people would try to argue he's untested, he didn't have this experience, and I would say, look, here's what I know. What I know about Americans is if you try something and it doesn't work, what they say is, here's what I know for sure, that didn't work, let's try something new. And the problem for the president on year four of his presidency is his idea of how to make this economy grow didn't work, and he didn't meet his own standard. He said, if you pass my stimulus, unemployment won't go above 8%. Instead, we've had the highest sustained unemployment since the Great Depression. It didn't work, and sooner or later, all of that comes crashing down on you. I agree with Margie. I think those numbers dropped so much because of the debt ceiling. But the other person who suffered is the president with his overall job approval and his number with independents.
All right. This is a little snapshot of the campaign to come. We'll come back and debate it again another day. Margie, Bill, appreciate
you,
your coming in. We come